Dear students, I welcome you all for this screencast lecture. This is related to the second question. As I already told, we will be covering the entire syllabus through the important questions that have been asked there in the semester examination. On this aspect, the second important question related to your soil and agriculture microbiology is give an account on microbial association in phytosphere. You just look at the image of the phytosphere. Phytosphere is made up of these following components. Phytosphere la edha pathi padipo, we will be reading about phyllosphere, then rhizosphere and then spermosphere. So in the moonu important sphere pathi padikiradha all together referred as a phytosphere. இது போக we will be studying something related to endophytes also. You look at the meaning for this term phytosphere. Phytosphere na enna? It refers to a living plant cover of the earth. The surface of aerial parts of the plant in their entirety. மொத்தமாக ஒரு plant கூட இருக்கிற என்னென்ன living spaces இருக்குதோ அதை எல்லாத்தையும் பத்தி படிக்கிறதா phytosphere. This term was coined by Tikhomirov in 1960. In the phytosphere la ingeyum pathina important the other spheres here they are denoting are phyllosphere, rhizosphere and spermosphere. So all these three spheres constitutes the phytosphere. We will look at the explanation about the different sphere. The first one is a rhizosphere. If you look at the definition, rhizosphere refers to region of soil adjacent to and surrounding the root. Apart from that, there is another term called as a rhizoplane. It refers to root surface. Okay. So the term rhizosphere was first introduced by Lorenz Hiltner. He is a German microbiologist. The term rhizosphere refers to region of the soil that has been influenced by the plant roots. And even a recent definition says by microorganism also it is influenced. So the concept of rhizosphere was proposed based on the works of Starkey et al, Kahl as well as Kasdanzan. All these persons have proposed that a mutual interaction has been occurring there in the roots and microorganism and soil. That is, rhizosphere can be referred as a tripartite association. Three components composed of roots, microorganism as well as the soil. Another term that is related with rhizosphere is rhizoplane, which was introduced by Clark. It refers to root surface that is closely adhering the soil particles are referred as a rhizoplane. So here, if you look at into this diagram, you can able to visualize how much of region in the root will be referred as a rhizosphere. If you exactly look at the region, it is more than 5 millimeter away from the root region can be referred as a rhizosphere. So this is the 5 millimeter region that has been shown there by giving some specific dyes there to the plant system. So when this dye has been taken, it has been exuded through the roots and that is the one which is shown there in that image. There is also another term here in the rhizosphere, that is RS ratio. It denotes to the ratio between the microbial population in the rhizosphere and to that of the microbial population in the soil. So it says to how much degree or extent plant roots can able to influence the microorganisms. So if you look at into this diagram, which again explains to how much region from the root is being subjected there to the rhizosphere. The surface of the root is referred there by rhizoplane. And a 5 to 7 millimeter that has been influenced by the root exudates is referred as a rhizosphere region. In this rhizosphere region, a lot of microorganisms will be commonly present. If you look at into this diagram, you can find out what are all the microorganisms that have been present there. So the signaling compounds are all those that have been produced by the root region, especially from the root hair, which attracts lot of bacteria there. Say for example, in the legume plants, in the rhizosphere region, the rhizobium has been present, which starts infecting the plant with the help of infection threat, which later forms into a nodule structure. Apart from that, In this rhizosphere region, a lot of different organisms could be present here, which includes the bacteria, then certain protozoa, even certain viruses, say bacteriophages. This is a bacteriophage, and lot of different kinds of bacteria. So here the organism present could be of both these kinds. Some organism may be of a plant growth promoting, that is referred as a plant growth promoting rhizobacteria, whereas there will be a chance for pathogenic organisms also present there in the rhizosphere. We will see still more details about the rhizosphere in a separate. Now we look at into the next sphere, that is phyllosphere. It also having another region called as a phylloplane. So if we carefully look at the definition, phyllosphere refers to region on and around a leaf surface is called as a phyllosphere. And the term phylloplane especially refers to surface of the leaves. The microorganism that commonly inhabitates or present there in the phyllosphere are referred by a term called as epiphytes. This image shows the activities or functions of phyllosphere microorganism. They are all exopolysaccharide production. This exopolysaccharide help in adhering of this bacteria there to the leaf surface. They are involved there in the nitrogen cycling. Even some nitrogen fixing organisms are present there in the leaf surface. Pigment producers. Some organisms present there in the leaf surface are specifically able to produce certain carotenoid pigments. An example is a methylobacterium. They are also referred as a pink pigmented facultative methylotrophs. This organism also produces a lot of volatile compounds from the leaf surface that helps in the plant growth. Apart from that, an important property there with the organism in the leaf surface is they are capable of producing hormones and various biosurfactant substances. Say the hormone producing example is again the methylobacterium that produces the cytokinin hormone there. Then these organisms are colonizing there with the help of a quorum sensing mechanism, and the motility is also a property among the bacteria or microorganism present there in the phyllosphere. The next one is spermosphere. So spermosphere is something which is extending up to 5 to 10 millimeter region there from the seed, that is from an imbibed seed. So imbibed seed further produces the root, that is through formation of radical. What is meant by imbibed seed? Look at this particular image, you can able to understand what is the meaning for an imbibed seed. So you are keeping the dry seeds there in the water. When you keep it for a overnight, the seeds will be getting soaked and they will take the water. As a result, they will be formed into swollen seeds. So these swollen seeds further produces the radical root as well as the shoot region. So thus the spermosphere refers to a small zone around the seeds, that is in the imbibed seed. It is up to some 2 to even sometime 12 millimeter region from the seed. So this particular region is the place where interaction between soil, microbial communities and germinating seeds will be taking place, and this particular effect will be long lasting impact on the plant system. What are the compounds that will be commonly exuded there from the seeds? So there is three different peaks of exudation can be observed on a seed, which includes an initiation of the exudation during seed imbibition, and then the next exudation during the few hours after the imbibition, and the third kind of a exudation is during the radical emergence stage. Exudation appadina secretion of some chemicals from the imbibed seed, adha they used to call as a exudates, seed exudates. In the exudates la enna enna irukum, here it contains carbohydrate, organic acid, various alcohol, fatty acids, amino acids, protein, and even certain secondary metabolites and inorganic ions will be present in a more amount there in this kind of a exudates. What are the microbial communities that could be present there in the spermosphere? They can be of a two origins. They can come from the host plant itself, or they can come from the soil dependent. That is, or host plant la the seed form agapodu and the seed koodiye microorganism will be coming. Abdi illana the microorganism will be originating there from the soil. So these are the two places from which the microbes will be entering there into the seed system. Enna na microbes anga irukum appdin pathina, a lot of gram negative and gram positive bacteria, true fungi such as a fungi that belongs to Ascomycota, and even certain fungi like organisms they used to call straminophils. Example is a Oomycota. Oomycota and a group of organisms, ellame, they will be present in more amount there in the seed. Here is a list of organisms that have been enriched. Enriched அப்படினா நேச்சுரலா present கிடையாது. நீங்க ஆர்டிஃபிஷியலா அந்த சீடுக்குள்ள இருக்க சில ஆர்கனிசத்தை ஆட் பண்றீங்க. ஆட் பண்றதால வாட் இஸ் த அட்வான்டேஜ் தேர் ஃபார் த பிளான்ட் சிஸ்டம். இப்ப பாத்தீங்கன்னா அசோஸ்பைரலம் பிரேசிலன்ஸ் இந்த பர்டிகுலர் ஆர்கனிசத்தை வந்து சீட்ல இன்வைட் பண்ண வைக்கிறது மூலம் யூ கேன் ஏபிள் டு ப்ரொமோட் த சீட் ஜெர்மினேஷன். மெயினா பாத்தீங்கன்னா இதுல வர்ற மேக்ஸிமம் ஆர்கனிசம் தட் வில் பி பிளேயிங் ஏ ரோல் தேர் இன் த இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் த பெர்சன்டேஜ் ஆஃப் சீட் ஜெர்மினேஷன். ப்ரொமோட் சீட் ஜெர்மினேஷன், ப்ரொமோட் சீட் ஜெர்மினேஷன். சம் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆர்கனிசம், சே ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் என்ட்ரோபாக்டர் க்ளோயோகே, தே கேன் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் ஏ ஃபஞ்சை பித்தியம் அல்டிமம். திஸ் ஃபஞ்சை கேன் ஏபிள் டு காஸ் ராட்டிங் தேர் ஆன் த ஜெர்மினேட்டிங் சீட்லிங்ஸ். அதை தடுக்கிறது குட் பி பாசிபிள் பை திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் ஆர்கனிசம், தட் இஸ் என்ட்ரோபாக்டர் க்ளோயோகே. அதே மாதிரி இன்னொரு எக்ஸாம்பிள் தான் சூடோமோனாஸ் க்ளோரோராஃபிஸ், விச் கேன் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் த சீட் பான் டிசீசஸ். சீட்ஸ் வழியா ஸ்ப்ரெட் ஆகிற டிசீசஸ் இந்த பர்டிகுலர் ஆர்கனிசத்தை என்ரிச் பண்றது மூலம் நாம கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணலாம். ஸோ லைக் திஸ் இஃப் யூ லேர்ன் எ ஃபியூ எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் மைக்ரோ ஆர்கனிசம் தேர் இன் த சீட் தட் கேன் ஏபிள் டு இன்ஃபுளுன்ஸ் த பிளான்ட் சிஸ்டம், தட் வில் பி எனஃப் ஃபார் யுவர் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங்.